Suntanned California has always been a place where people come to experiment with their identity. Thus, the name is perfect for Ferrari's lowest-priced model, which has been an experiment since it first hit the streets in 2009. It was the first road-going Ferrari to put a V8 in front of its driver and the first with a power retractable hardtop, and its price and daily practicality took Ferrari on a low pass through the market. It probably should have been a Maserati, as it would have done far more to elevate that brand than it does for Ferrari. But the ball didn't bounce that way. Secretive Ferrari won't say how the Z California sells. But judging by the plethora of low-mileage examples parked on eBay with heavily depreciated prices, the market is perhaps lukewarm. The revamped X80 just 14 seconds turns this well-insulated hardtop coupe into a convertible fixes what may have gone wrong with the old model, including a challenged power-to-weight ratio and styling that evoked a pouting teenager more than the snarling stallions of Maranello. The T stands for turbo, of course, and in this regard the California, with its twin compressors hanging from a smaller 3.9-liter V8 with a signature flat plane crankshaft, is being experimental yet again. This is the first forced induction street Ferrari since the F40, and so it is the pathfinder for the many turbocharged Ferraris to come, starting with a U set to arrive early next year. The new sheet metal picks up themes from the U, replacing the soft roundness and elliptical headlights with Ferrari's newer angular look. That includes more scalloping for ducts and vents, and the droopy black inset panel in back is gone and unlamented, as are the silly stacked pipes that help tighten the car's already tall tush and give it a